Hey students, here Sampada Kulkarni welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. In this video series, I am explaining you the concept of circular queue data structure. Till now, I have explained many of the things with respect to circular queue. For your reference, I am providing a shortcut link in this write-up corner. You can go through the previous sessions. Because unless and until you are not able to understand the basics related to circular queue, you will not be able to understand the current video. So before moving to the content, I would like to request you to subscribe my channel Tech Talks and keep the bell ringing. So dear friends, let's start with the current video session with the operations on circular queue. So here I am explaining you what different operations we can perform on a circular queue. So let's see which operations we can perform on a circular queue. So the first operation that can be performed on a circular queue is nothing but the insert operation. Here we are going to insert the elements onto the circular queue. Now let's see the second operation that can be performed on a circular queue is nothing but the deletion operation. So here in this deletion operation, we can perform delete element from the circular queue. And the next operation that can be performed on a circular queue is nothing but the display operation, where we can display the contents of a circular queue. What the elements are available in the current position in a circular queue that can be known with the display operation. Now let's see what different condition we supposed to check while performing these different operations. So whenever we are going to perform the first operation, that is insertion operation, we supposed to check whether the queue is overflow or not. If the queue is overflowing, if the answer of this question is yes, then we can't perform the insert operation. We can perform the insertion element into the circular queue till the queue is not overflowing. Overflow it means that your queue is not having sufficient space to accommodate the new data into the circular queue. Now let's see, the second operation is nothing but the delete operation, and before performing the delete operation, what the condition we supposed to check. So the condition is nothing but the underflow condition. What we supposed to do, we supposed to check whether any element is available in your circular queue or not to perform the delete operation. Unless and until your circular queue is available with the elements, you can't perform the delete operation. It means that if here we are going to check if the queue is empty, then we can't perform the delete operation, because if no any element is available in your queue, then how could you delete the element from the queue? So that's why we are going to check whether the queue is underflowing or not. If the answer to this question is yes, then we can't perform the delete operation. And if it is not underflowing, then we can perform the delete operation. Now let's see the third operation. All of you are knowing the third operation is nothing but the display the content of a circular queue. Then what the condition we supposed to check to perform the display operation. Again, we have to check here the underflow condition, that is empty condition. If your queue is empty, if your queue is underflowing, it means that nothing is available in your queue, then you can't perform the display operation. So in this way, we can perform these three operations. The first one is insertion. In that case, we supposed to check whether your queue is full or overflow or not. To perform the delete operation, we supposed to check whether queue is underflow or empty or not. And again, to perform display operation also, we supposed to check whether the queue is circular queue is underflow or empty or not. Here, if you are knowing the concepts related to linear queue, the things are same. The same way we are going to perform in a linear queue. Only the conditions are different while implementing them. I'll explain you in detail while implementing the circular queue what we supposed to exactly check to perform overflow condition, to underflow condition, and so on. Right now, theoretically, I am explaining you the conditions that we supposed to check to perform different operations on a queue. Before moving to the detail of these operations, we supposed to remember the points. They are, while performing insertion and a deletion operation, we are keeping these points in our memory, that we are going to use the rear and front pointers separately for these two operations. They are nothing but insertion and deletion operation. So while performing insertion operation, we'll use the rear pointer. While performing deletion operation, we'll use a front pointer. So let's see the uses of the rear and front pointers separately. So the first is nothing but the rear pointer tracks the last element of a queue, while front pointer tracks the first element of a queue, because always the insertion operations are performed at the end of the queue and the front operation are performed onto the first element of the queue. The second point we supposed to remember is nothing but rear pointer takes the responsibility to insert an element, as I explained previously, and other way around, the front pointer takes the responsibility to delete the element. And the third point we supposed to keep in mind is nothing but rear pointer helps us to check the overflow condition, and the front pointer helps us to check the underflow condition. So in this way, both the pointers helps us to perform insertion and deletion operation separately. And now if we'll go forward to perform the delete operation, what the points we supposed to keep in mind? So in this case, to perform the display operation, both, that is rear and for front pointers, we are going to use combinedly. Both the operators will use to perform the display operation. So the first thing we are going to keep in mind is nothing but, as a queue data is only the data between front and rear pointer. The valid data is available between the front and rear pointer. Wherever front is pointing, from that front to the rear pointer only, it will be having the valid data, and that will help us to display the content of a circular queue. So while displaying the elements of circular queue, display the data available between front and rear pointer only, because they are only having the valid data, and the rest of the data outside of a front and rear pointer are nothing the part of the circular queue, that we are not at all going to consider them, because here we are going to perform the logical deletion operation onto the circular queue. So though data is available, that we are not going to consider that data, because only the data will be available in a circular queue will be valid if it is between front and rear pointer. So in this way, this is nothing but the introduction to the different operations that can be performed on a circular queue with the help of front and rear pointers. In the detail, all these operations I am going to explain you in the next video. To understand more about the operations that can be performed on a circular queue, please stay tuned with my channel Tech Talks. So thank you dear friends for listening and watching my video. If you like the content and the video, please do not forget to give the comment. If you like and the content of a video, please do subscribe my channel. Here I am providing you a subscription link to subscribe my channel. Along with this, I am providing you a shortcut link for a next video, that is insertion operation in detail, and the whole playlist also I am providing here for your reference. Thank you. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Happy data structuring. Happy learning.